नमस्ते एंड वेलकम एवरीवन फॉर आवर ज़ोडियाक साइंस एंजल सोल गाइडेंस फॉर द मंथ ऑफ मई 2020. द ऑनसेट ऑफ द मंथ हैज बीन वेरी वेरी टफ फॉर मेनी पीपल. द लास्ट 2-3 मंथ्स हैज बीन रियली टफ एंड चैलेंजिंग फॉर द एंटायर वर्ल्ड. एंड बिफोर आई स्टार्ट आई वुड लाइक टू maintain with you all 1 minute silence in love, blessings, strength and courage, healing and wisdom for the entire world. And may we all overcome this challenge with the true victory of the human spirit. Please join me in 1 minute of silence to pray to God, the universe and all of divinity for all of humanity and creation. मेहर बाबा की जय. थैंक यू फॉर ज्वाइनिंग इन दिस 1 मिनट ऑफ साइलेंस एंड प्रेयर. सो वी शैल बिगिन आवर ज़ोडियाक साइंस एंजल सोल गाइडेंस एंड सी व्हाट द एंजल्स एंड द यूनिवर्स हैव टू टेल ईच ऑफ दीज साइंस. एंड दो एज आई ऑलवेज से दैट दीज आर फॉर द ब्रॉडर यूनिवर्सल एनर्जीज पर्टेनिंग टू दीज साइंस, you will see a lot of overlap in some other sign as well. So make sure that you listen to all the signs and not just your sign and then wish off. It also will help you to understand the things that your family or friends and surrounding people would be going through, so that you can be more compassionate and more supportive on their journey when you know what's in store for them as well through this month. So please be there throughout and patiently listen to what the angels and the universe have to tell you. There will also be a positive energy color for the month that will be shared for each of the signs. Utilize that color throughout the month or on any important days. Right now we are not having any meetings or anything, but yet for any important thing you can visualize the color for healing, for manifestation or any such aspect which is vital to your life in this month. If there are any number related messages coming up while I'm channeling, then I will pick out a chip pertaining to a number and share that as well for that sign. We first begin with the zodiac sign of Aries, governed by Archangel Ariel. For this month of May, the Aries are being told that it is time to step out of any fear or ego of asking help from others. The universe wants you to approach people for whatever help, collaboration, association that you wish to create for and with them. It is a great month to associate with others and have absolutely no qualms and no resistance, no withholding to ask for that help. You are being told that you will also be attracting the right person for some work related matter, something that you wanted to do in your work, in your profession, in your entrepreneurship or something of that sort, and it will help you to approach the right person in your circle for that matter. You are being asked not to again stop from that asking due to preconceived notions that, oh, it may be so and this person may not be interested or this person may not want to do it. Don't judge at the onset and rather go ahead and do the needful and speak to the person about your project, about your idea or whatever it may be, so that you also get a feedback even if that person is not the person. So there will always be a learning even if you get a no from someone. And asking is a part of humility, because it is not, in fact, just as it's misconstrued as weakness. Asking help is a weakness. No. It actually is a courageous act to ask for help, because it thrashes our false ego of, no, I don't want help. I don't want to ask someone. And so it will help you to break any such egoistic aspect due to insecurity or fear, or because in your past you have been told no and people have not been very helpful to you. Even if that is so, you are being guided that you release this fear and open your heart to love. God is all about love. So open your heart to God's love and approach it with that love, and you will sure tap upon meeting that right person, speaking to that right person about the said matter. The positive color, energy color for the month is light pink for you. Beautiful color of love. So utilize this light pink and make sure that you are doing and saying things only and only out of love. Beautiful. So the one word card that I will pick up for each of the zodiac signs. For the Aries, the word is birth. How beautiful, and coinciding with your message that there will be a birth of a new thing which is at the forthcoming energetic orbit, and you are being asked to do everything that you can so that you can give birth to this concept, this idea, this company, this product, or whatever it could be in your life. And for some, it could also be birth of a child of their own or someone in the family. We now move on to the zodiac sign of Taurus, governed by Archangel Shamuel and Archangel Ariel. The Taurus sign is being told that this month, utilize the time that is gifted to you to relax and open your mind. Your mind possibly has been very closed or narrowed in thinking about certain matters of life. There could also be rigidity and stubbornness in those matters, and you are being guided to release that. You are being directed to do some spiritual practice that will open up your intuition, that will open up and awaken the God's voice within you, which is within each of us. And to daydream, create your vision, create your goals, and set mini goals, set these little baby steps towards doing things. This time is your seat for creativity. And this month will give you beautiful, powerful ideas. Maybe you wanted to write that book, maybe you wanted to journal something, that blog, or something you wanted to step out with. This is a great time. And the angels and the universe are also guiding you to notice your emotions and feelings which you have been disregarding since quite some time. You've been neglecting and dishonoring your emotions. They are guiding you that it is important to bring everything in balance, including your emotions and feelings. Being sensitive in the sense of being empathic is different from being sensitive of breaking down at everything. So you are being asked to strengthen your spiritual and inner immunity so that you can start standing up for your emotions and feelings and standing up for your own truth in life. Be careful of procrastination and inertia and laziness in this month. The one word for you, how beautifully, it's just amazing how the card message, the angelic message, universal message, and these words that I'm picking up from this bowl are absolutely in sync. The word is authenticity. Please be authentic with yourself, with your emotions, with your feelings. No people pleasing, no hanji when you want to say a no. Use the power of no and stand up for your inner truth. Have that willpower and courage to be inconsequential when it comes to your truth. The positive energy color for this month for the Taurians is maroon. Utilize the color throughout the month for healing, for on important days with your spiritual practices, affirmative practices, goal setting, whatever that you may do. This color will exert and resonate its healing energies for you in this month. We now move on to the zodiac sign of Geminis, governed by Archangel Zadkiel and Archangel Gabriel. For the Geminis this month, there are two cards, and you are being applauded for optimizing your quiet solitude and retreat time, creating an abundance mindset for yourself and the world. And the angels and the universe are guiding to comply by all the good things that you are following or that which you are implementing, and to have sustainability in that, to have, you know, perseverance to see them through and continue doing them. Do not leave them in, you know, midway. Do not give up if at all something is not going the way it has to, or the way you want to rather. See, feel and think and speak about abundance all the time, because you are in a high manifesting period and you will be generating and manifesting all the good things that you want to do for yourself and others. It is a beautiful period where it is showing that you will be spreading the abundance into the world. The abundance of wisdom, the abundance of empowerment, the abundance of joy, happiness, time, creativity. It will all be coming to you many folds while you keep on sharing with the world. So the universe is guiding you that you are sitting on top of this large, you know, melting pot of abundance, and you will keep filling it in as it melts its glory and its joy into the lives of others. So please continue doing that. You are also being guided to create more quiet time for your spiritual practices, for any positive practices, yoga, breathing, and so on. Because this time is also a time in the last 4 to 5 months, your energy has been elevating, your energy has been changing drastically, and you are being guided to keep up in line with this energy. These vibrations are accelerating for you especially, and you are being guided to do everything that you can meticulously to raise your vibrations and frequency more and more, so that you can be a far better version than yesterday for the world. The positive energy color for this month is the beautiful blue for the Geminis. Let's see the one word. Faith. Beautiful. So this month you are also going to be increasing in your faith. Faith in yourself, faith in your work, faith in your self-confidence, self-worth, self-deservingness, and faith in the larger aspect of life and the universe. Faith in God. So all those who may have been going through any roller coasters will come back to their faith in this month. So hold on to God tightly and tell Him, pray to Him that He holds you tight in His faith so that you don't slip on from there. We now move on to the zodiac sign of Cancer, governed by Archangel Gabriel. This month, the Cancerians are being guided to pay attention and focus on balance in life. There are parts of life there has been slight or more imbalance in your health, especially you are being guided, and your relationships. So please bring in a balance and know that any kind of compromise is a compromise with your soul. Please do away with any compromise. Please do away with any kind of shortcut and midway finding that you might be trying to do in matters. And this is not going to be very, very good for you. The universe is also guiding that bring a little compassion and humility in your relationships and treat everyone equally. There are times where subconsciously due to your past events or, you know, situations in your life or the conditioning that is imprinted in you, you treat people according to what they are in life and not for who they are told, you know, truly. So this has been causing a little strain in your relationships, and you're being guided that the beautiful soul that you are, please bring those attributes to surface and allow your love and your compassion to shine through you and make it happen from this month onwards, because the energies are very, very high for you to harmonize all your relationships. The one word for this month is expansiveness. Isn't that beautiful? So expand yourself, expand the energy of love and compassion in your life, the energy of understanding, the energy of reaching out, supporting, and bringing in that balance that is much required in every aspect of your life right now, or most of the aspect as it is being guided. The positive energy color for the Cancer is lavender. Utilize the color and allow the resonating, you know, healing energies of this color to help you and assist you in this month. We now move on with the zodiac sign of Leo, governed by Archangel Raziel. Okay, so we have something popped out for the Leos. How amazing! It is reassuring to the Leos that you need to know and believe in the deepest core of your existence that God is your source, is the source for all of us and all of creation. Your faith may be shaking. Your faith may be going little downhill. Your trust in life may be going little downhill. But know that there are infinite doors that faith is opening up for you in the forthcoming time. This month is for you to stay open to receiving new things, new learning, new approach, seeing life with new eyes. It could be anything which is new and which is going to break free from the lack and limitation thinking that you've been having in certain aspects of life. There is plenty of abundance to share, and they want you to know that it is important to be open to receiving abundance from wherever universe is sending you. Abundance of love, appreciation, joy, happiness. Stop narrowing down and limiting your search, because God is everywhere and in everything. Stop limiting your search to wanting that love and appreciation only from certain corners of life. And be open and honor and acknowledge all the forms and ways from where God is reaching out to you. But you are stopping it. So don't do that. Release any kind of, cringing due to lack of love that you may have not received in life. Know that everybody is in its innate innocence like a lamb, who is a synonym of innocence. And then situations of life adulterates everyone. It dilutes and diminishes the spark in everyone, including you, each one of you. And see others who are unhealed in that same compassion, with that same eyes of love that God sees you with. And then you shall hold no hurt, no resentments, no hatred, no unforgiveness. Ask and pray to God to return you and everyone else who may have hurt you to the innocence of that lamb, to the innocence of the true existence resting within you. How beautiful is that, my God? You will be able to shine through when you stop expecting in life, but start manifesting in life rather. The power lies with you. So shine on. And this beautiful star right there is denoting and giving out the message that you are ready to shine on. But you are the only one who is putting a curtain to that illuminance. So ask God's help to remove that curtain so that you can shine yourself into the world. Let's see the one word. Beautiful acceptance. What more could be in sync? Acceptance of your own self, acceptance of your worth, acceptance of your existence, and acceptance of all others around you. Acceptance for who they are. And to allow each one's journey to be so, while you contribute only and only good to it. So, open your arms and say, there's this beautiful small thing called welcome. And yes, welcome and accept the abundance, appreciation and love that God is bringing you, which they just said. So please do that. And open your heart, open your arms, open your energy. And allow God's love to permeate you. So that there is no space for anything else that is of lower vibrancy. The positive energy color for the month for Leos is the emerald green. The emerald green of healing. So please utilize this month to heal everything that you have to. And just be gritted with great fortitude and tenacity that you are going to finish all of this and then fly free of all baggage in your life. We now move on to the zodiac sign of Virgo, governed by Archangel Metatron and Archangel Ariel. This month, the Virgos are being told that you need to focus on relationship aspect and to know that relationships are not just about the one that you share with others, but the most important relationship that is there in life to be shared is the relationship with your own self, the relationship with your soul, and that in interdependency denotes and describes the kind of relationship that you will have with others. Relationship with God, relationship with the supreme power, the universe, your relationship with life. So mend the ways and corners of life where this relationship with yourself is strained. The moment you mend this self-relationship, you will start seeing other relationships harmonize and ease out as well. You are being guided to remove all thoughts of struggle. Struggle in fitting in life. Struggle of craving for love. Struggle for demanding love. Demanding appreciation. Or demanding people pay attention to you. Or demanding that people listen to you. Stop demanding. Allow your love and compassion and actions to command it. And you will get it. The universe is asking you to feel safe and loved within first. And the moment you do that, you will open up a Mary Poppins bag of talents, gifts, and so many things in your life. Your relationship with yourself has been strained. For many, it has been from childhood. But for some, it has been since the last 9 to 11 years period is coming up. And look at the events in this period or from childhood, whatever is applicable to you. And you are being guided to hold tight, in love and compassion first to yourself. And say, I love you, I forgive you, thank you for your existence, everything that you wanted to yourself first. And then extend the love to others as well. Health will need to be taken care of some loved one, some relationship in this month. There is nothing to panic or worry. Just look out for health. So make sure that you're taking precautions or you are adhering to your regular medication. If at all anybody who already has some ailment, don't neglect your health is what is being told in this month especially. The positive energy color for the month for Virgos is the earth brown. Do some grounding, walk bare feet in your home. Sit on the ground and meditate. Touch the ground whenever you can. And pray to Mother Earth to fill you with her vital energies and keep you grounded and anchored in her love at all times. Beautiful. Let's see the board. Discernment. So very important, especially in relationships. So please exercise discernment and know that it is your birthright to do so. You don't have to, feel bad or feel guilty about discerning something. So make sure you utilize your free will in the right way, in the right form, for the right choices. We now move on to the zodiac sign of Libra, governed by Archangel Jophiel. For the Librans this month, you are being guided to focus on prayers, focus on asking in the sense not of wants, but asking for the right things, asking for discipline in life, asking for wisdom, asking for healing for the areas that you need in life. Pray, give glory and thanks to God for everything that you have, and at the same time ask for these attributes to be heightened and to manifest them in your life. There have been these pockets of life which needs attention, which were just mentioned to you, with discipline, with self-care. Prayer time, exercise. So in self-care, exercise particularly is coming up. So please adhere to that and see what you can do in this given month to bring about this change that will help you in your forward path as well. You are also being guided to ask for focus and clarity. There are particularly one or two matters in your life right now that are in confusion or are kind of veiled in some way, where the real thing is not known to you or shown to you. And you are being asked to ask for clarity to see the underlying truth. And the moment you see that, you will be able to make a more informed decision about this matter. Do not go in haste and make a decision about these one or two matters that are, persistently hovering in your life right now. You have great blessings from your maternal grandparents, which are working big time since the last 1 year especially, because your life has been needing it. So give gratitude to your grandparents who may have moved on in the maternal lineage. Even if it is not the immediate, it could be your great grandparents, because being spirit guides or blessing us is not pertaining to the fact whether we have really met our grandparents or great grandparents. Even if you've not met, their energy and their spirits are blessing you from heavens above and protecting you and watching over you. The one word for this month is creativity. So with all that you have to do, with self-care, with this, with that, with discipline, bring about some creative innovation, bring about creativity in all that you do, and you shall not feel it as a normal chore. Bring about that excitement, and then you will be able to have creative, you know, results in all that you do. We now move on to the zodiac sign of Scorpio, governed by Archangel Jeremiel and Archangel Gabriel. The Scorpions are being asked to look into their dietary habits, to focus on high energy food, clear energy food. It is also being guided that try to move away from meats and, you know, non-vegetarian food, because it has been extremely heavy on your energy. Many would have manifested physical ailments as well due to that, and you need to go and address it with a nutritionist, or, you know, just at your by your own self at your home. Please change your diet. Try to avoid fried and, you know, processed and boxed foods and packed foods, kind of a thing, and try to have as much as raw salads and fruits and, you know, fresh food as such. It will automatically elevate your energy levels and your health will start improving as well. This month is also a very good period to attract the right business partners or a suitable ideal life partner, and is going to be beneficial for relationships. So clear your energy so that you are not in a dilapidated state of low energy zone and, you know, attracting the wrong person or wrong people or wrong things in your life. You have been experiencing that as well. It's coming. But if you change the direction of what you are intaking, you will change the forthcoming, you know, journey of your health life as well. It is guided that many of you could bring in a pet this month, and that healing energy of the pet is going to be very, very helpful to you. Especially, you know, anything, cat or dog, but especially a cat energy is coming up, and it will be extremely healing. At the same time, enforcing the attributes of self-dependency, independence, discipline, focus from there. So see if you can bring in a pet and reach out to children. It's coming this month. Reach out to the children in your family, in your surroundings, in your neighborhood or your own, and see what you can do and extend a helping hand to bring to the table something more than the otherwise normal adult-child relationship. There's something more that you can give this month to the children energy, and in return also receive from them their clear and clean energy of love, innocence and faith. The positive energy color for this month is the lemon yellow for the Scorpions. Let's see the word. Celebration. Great. So isn't it beautifully in sync? That you may find either a partner or a life partner, business partner or life partner, or something is going to brew up there in this month, and it could be celebrating in your own sense. Right now, we are all in isolation. We are all curbed. We are all at home. So it may not be a big celebration, but the celebration essence is the essence of your spirit celebrating this new entry of something that's going to come into your life this month. Great. So congratulations. We now move on to the zodiac sign of Sagittarius, governed by Archangel Raguel. This is amazing. From another totally different deck altogether, the Sagittarians also are being guided that they could meet a new partner this month. Isn't it amazing? So the Sagittarians are being told that it would not be a chance meeting where somebody puts you on to someone and somebody says, oh, contact this person or contact this one, call that one, or somebody calls you for something and something more out of that could manifest. So be on the lookout and keep your heart and mind open for this new person to enter. It is divinely orchestrated, and you will have this sense of a strong gut feeling about it being right. Be very careful and pay attention to all the new people that Divinity is sending you. You will recognize them and you will have the sense of familiarity and comfort and safety with them. You also will be creating a new project or something to do with a new job or a new location, new house. Something within the new capacity of these 3-4 angles could take place from May onwards, kind of a thing. It's not that it will happen in May, but the month of May will kind of germinate the seed for it to flourish and blossom. So make sure that you nurture it and keep watering it in the rightful way with all your love, your strength, your courage, and your, you know, nourishing abilities, whatever is required for that. The positive energy color for this month is the pristine white for Sagittarians. So work with the white color and bring in all the goodness. Let's see the one word for Sagittarians. Flexibility. So be flexible, and they just said in the earlier message that be open and be careful and pay attention. So don't allow old situations or old parameters of life to bring an equal to in your mindset and say, oh, that happened like that, so this will happen like this. No. Treat it differently, treat it with love, and treat it with a positive mindset. Be flexible in other people's, ideas or what the other person is saying. Even if you may not be in total sync with it, just deliberate on it and then make a conscious decision about it. Also get into some yoga, aerobics, or something that you can do at home right now, and increase your physical flexibility as well, because the tangible flexibility will help the inner energetic flexibility to come into sync and alignment. Lovely. We now quickly move on to the Capricorn, governed by Archangel Osriel and Archangel Ariel. The Capricorns are being told that this month could see a change in direction. There are changes that have been divinely guided in the past almost a year and a half. And there is a absolutely newly birthed willingness to be open to change that has come into you, and they want you to keep on with it. You are protected now and in the future and at all times, and follow the path of your inner happiness. You may have been doing a lot of things which please others and keep others happy, but it is time to focus on your inner self. Certain practices, certain learnings and things that can help your inner world, that can help your inner strength to emerge, is required right now. So go back to any practices that you may have been doing or left behind, or something that you can do now with like-minded people, with nurturing people who can help you in this mentoring journey and be with you together. This is also a month of happy outcomes to things that you really desire to do. Some business, some venture, some product, something will be birthed in this month. There is a lot of birthing in the month of May. Wow. There is some child news somewhere in the family or in your own life that is, emerging as well. And be open to observing your children, because they have been teaching you a lot as well. You've been taking in a lot of wisdom from just seeing your children do and say things in a certain way. And there are certain revelations of your own childhood that have been coming up. So the universe is guiding you that keep doing that and keep observing them and absorbing the best that you can from them, so that you do not operate out of any unhealed energies of your own childhood and are able to give to them a fresh perspective, a fresh new look and direction to life as well. The positive energy color for the Capricorns is the golden yellow. So utilize the beautiful golden yellow this month and allow its energies to resonate in your life. The one word is adventure. You are quite an adventurous soul. You love adventure. You love outdoors as well. It is guided. And you treat life as an adventure as well. And they are guiding you that never ever stop operating from that perspective. And make the fullest out of your life with gratitude and blessings. Give when you are in abundance. Share when you are in abundance. Even if it is little, share with others what you can, and you will be gifted with much more. We now move on to the zodiac sign of Aquarius, governed by Archangel Uriel. The Aquarians are being told that just as nature is all bountiful, there is immense amount of abundance that is lined up in your life. The month of May is going to open you to a higher vibration and God's infinite abundance. They are being also guided to go out more in nature. Take a walk in the park. Go to the beach, put your feet into the waters, dip your feet there, bless the water, feel the energy of the water, and connect with nature in a more, energetic essence, in a more metaphoric way, and pray that you are infused with all these, vital, strong energies of Mother Nature, which will help you in your forthcoming work, in your business. You are love pets. Spend energy if you have a pet or if you are having any pets in the surroundings. Try to sit in quietude for 5-10 minutes under a tree or in the park or the garden or on your terrace under the stars if possible. And do some activity that will create and generate something good for the environment, for the animals or so. Nature is at its highest best energy with you in this month. And something concerning nature, animals, environment is up your alley. And you are being guided to forge ahead and manifest that and do everything that you can to bring it into action. Bring some plants home and connect with the unconditional energy of the plant, which gives fragrance if it is a flower plant or just gives beauty. Connect with that energy and thank the plant for its unconditionality and help that, help yourself by taking in that energy of unconditional love from the plant and ask that it permeates you as well. This month is great for reconnecting to your inner self and getting back to any spiritual practices, affirmative practices, life-affirming practices that you may have kept away or, been a little far off from there. You are being asked to reconnect as the beautiful shining rays of divinity are shining upon you from this month onwards to work on your spiritual growth alongside your material growth. The positive energy color is turquoise for the Aquarians this month. I love the turquoise color as well. And now for the last zodiac sign, the Pisces, governed by Archangel Sandalphon and Archangel Gabriel. Lovely. So, the Pisces are being told that this month could see a emergence of two great strengths. Maybe a family or a friend, a colleague or an associate or your own boss or something is going to be converging for a larger benefit of a project or something of that sort which is coming up. There is also wedding up the alley for many of the Pisces, and it may not be that the physical wedding may take place, but the wedding may be arranged or wedding may be decided, or you may be deciding to step ahead in your commitment zone and commit to a relationship that you have been in. Or it could be finding. So this month is also about, as I see with so many signs, is also about finding the right partner or right people, either it was business or like this, a life partner. So that's beautiful. And they want to guide you that wedding or convergence of two strengths meeting is not just this meeting for that particular thing, but it is a deepening bond of the human spirit that comes together for a larger picture, for the larger good. And they want you to always keep that in mind, that anything that you do, see and try to put into action, what is the larger benefit for humanity or for people beyond your obvious circle, that it is going to be helpful in. Continually breathe life into commitment, faith, and trust. Trust has been a little issue with you. You may have taken long to trust people, you may have taken long to trust a relationship and commit to that relationship, but they are asking you to work on trust matters. Trust your own self. There may have been wrong decisions you've taken in the past, it is coming, and you kind of disrespect yourself for that, or you feel guilty for that, you regret that, and with that fear you are not wanting to trust the decisions you make. So you are being guided that pray upon, move towards some, you know, good thoughts, practices that will help you to change that feeling and heal these old wounds that are making you mistrust yourself and life at large. The positive energy color for the Pisces . It's taking long to come. Is the bright orange. So work with the orange for this month and heal, you know, matters of unfulfillment in your life that could have been there as well. And here is your one card, one word, willingness. So have the willingness to trust, have the willingness to commit, have the willingness to see and approach life with a lot more faith and love. So with this, we complete all our zodiac signs. Nilufar Zaveri and many others have earlier asked, and I have many times answered this as well, that the messages that are guided are universal messages, and they are predominantly connected to the sun sign. But actually, if you see your ascending sign or if you see your moon sign and listen to those messages, there are many people who connect with the moon sign as well, because it is a sign that is existing and that is exerting its energies upon you. So these are universal messages, and both could be applicable in its bits and parts for you. So please listen to even the messages from the perspective of the moon sign. But predominantly, the synergy that you might find is with the sun signs. Yet, do not, kind of neglect, and you could get an important message from the message of your moon sign as well. So I hope that has cleared your doubts about the sun sign and the moon sign issue. And the difference actually is zodiac by itself is the sun sign, and the moon sign is the Rashi or the astrological sign, as we call as well. So moon sign is the Rashi sign and the sun sign is the birth sign, the date of birth sign, as we call it as. So I hope this has been helpful. Please utilize the guidance in your life and allow the guidance to be your wonderful GPS guiding you to drive well. But as I always say, the driving is our part, it's our bit, and we have the free will to yet take the wrong turn, even if the GPS is guiding us to take the right turn. So make sure that you are in compliance with the guidance. Utilize the colors, the positive energy colors for the month to, you know, enhance further your projects, your time, your relationships, and so on. And with that, since we are in this midst of challenging times, let us chant and close this session with Baba's name 9 times and Om 9 times. So just relax yourself as we chant Meher Baba's name. We chant with the intention of healing vibrations generated through this chant to reach out to all humanity and through all self-created sufferings, physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual. मेहर बाबा 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 टेक अ डीप ब्रेथ एंड वी चैंट ओम Love and light of God. May we all hold on to that supreme power till the very end. So have a lovely time ahead, a lovely month ahead, and utilize this isolation not as a prison but as a time to optimize your spiritual, physical, mental, and emotional immunity. Stay in prayers, meditation, affirmations, and allow good thoughts, good words, and good deeds to surround you as you're surrounded with good and beautiful people who you love. Thank you so much for being with me. A very, very, very big namaste. Please share these videos with one and all. Like, put your love hearts to it, put your insights and comments to what you resonated with, and it shall help me to give more gratitude to Divinity for all that it flows and all that it does. Thank you so much. Please like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I shall be putting this on YouTube as well. And share the link with one and all. Love you all. Namaste. Have a beautiful day ahead.